What I wanted to show you is something we've been thinking about and that we're super excited. So internet's becoming, you know, more and more video. And this is a problem, right? Because if you're like me, you're starting to consume a lot of your videos on Facebook, on your phone, without sound. This is a big problem because it means that if there is no subtitles in the videos, the users would just scroll. So suddenly there's a huge demand to have subtitles available for videos, especially on Facebook and other social platforms. And if your video has subtitles in English only, then fundamentally you're stuck to a couple of markets. So if you think about this, and I want to show you a little bit of how the future is going to look like. So I'm going to try and do something live. Let's see how this works. Okay. So let me do this. And then, okay. There we go. So this is my phone, as you can see. I'm just going to do a simple recording with you guys in the audience. So we're here at Pioneers in Vienna, demonstrating casts for Unbabel. From now on, video subtitling and promotion is going to be seamless. Okay, so now what you're seeing is the first thing that is happening is that we're going to be getting the automatic transcription and translation in one go. It's querying our service right now, and initially you get an automatic version, and then I'm going to show you how you can very seamlessly upgrade it to human, and hopefully you'll see some of the mistakes that I'm telling you of where deep learning fails, right? So you can see now we got the initial translation. One feels that tidally and promotions, right? That's not exactly what I said. Pioneers, you got right. That's great. And you have different languages here, right? So I can go on my phone and I can say, oh, let me see how this is in Spanish or Chinese or Japanese. Instantly, you have it available. The interesting part now is I'm now upgrading it to human. So what's going on right now is it's going through our community. So we have about 50,000 people all around the world that are now getting the audio of this, the initial speech recognition, improving that, and then subsequently they're going to improve the translation, right? And all of this is going to happen in a seamless way. And you're going to see some notifications arrive as that happens. So okay, so while that happens, I am going to try and move the slide here. I'm going to show you something while that happens. There we go. Okay. Cool. So the really cool thing here is actually not cast. This is a demo, right? This app, you know, hopefully you'll be able to use it soon. It's not on the App Store yet. But what we're really trying to show is the API behind it, right? Because until now, for the most part, this is a cumbersome thing. You had like a vendor for speech recognition and then something that would do the transcription, then you had to figure out subtitles. It was kind of a mess. With Cast, with the Unbabel video API, it's one endpoint, right? So it's going to be one connection. You just send us a video. You tell us, you know, how long or how many subtitles you want, in which languages, and voila, right? It's seamless. So for example, let me now switch to English because they have been improved. And let's see. Okay. So you can see now that it only recognized Pioneers probably, cast for Unbabel, and then from now on, video subtitle and captions are going to be seamless, right? That was a pretty good upgrade. And this happened, yeah, thank you, yeah. And this happened in a couple of minutes. And of course, the video is short, so you know there's something to that. But, and this now what's going to happen is, as the translations get fixed, you're going to get notifications, and the whole process is going to work, right? Typically, a video like this, a video for Facebook, 4 minutes, is going to take you 10 minutes to be ready to just publish. So for media content producers, it's going to be awesome, right? There's going to be one API you plug in, and that's basically it. So then what's next, right? So we're launching this. Super proud, super excited about this. I think it's going to be a huge impact. But what's next? Where do we see the world headed, right? I'm speaking here in English. Wouldn't it be awesome if there was some device that I could bring with me and would just have an holographic display that would show me speaking in different languages, right? So I could have subtitles in Chinese real time or Japanese. Imagine having business meetings where you can come in and see instantly what the other person is saying. So we're actually very close to being able to do that, not only because our ability to generate data is gigantic, but because we can do it in a really distributed way, even when you need a human, you will be able to do it in near real time. And so that's going to be another big game changer. We think video is becoming more and more important, and it's kind of the next step of communication, right? Eventually, and I believe very much in Elon Musk's vision of the neural link, and I think eventually we're going to be able to do real-time translation brain to brain, right? We're not quite there yet, but hopefully by next pioneers and can come and demonstrate that. If you want to try the Unbabel Video API, just talk to me. So right now it's in beta. We're taking new partners. And I'm happy to answer any questions you might have. We're Unbabel. We're changing the way communication happens. Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. All right. So we have a few questions on Slido. Everyone, slido.com, if you would like to ask some questions. You can even go there right now, and we'll answer them on the spot if we have time. So Alexander asks, why would I translate audio for free for your service?
Well, you don't translate for free. People get paid. Every time a human touches, you know, the audio or the text, they get paid.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, they get paid between $8 and $20 an hour, depending on how good and how fast they are.
Fantastic. And that's anywhere in the world someone can
anywhere in the world. Right now, we're... Thank you. Yeah, it's...
Happy about that.
Yeah. Yeah. So right now, we're keep it simple, and so we pay the same rates. This works great for some countries, less great for others. In the future, we're going to be starting differentiating, but for now, it's the same.
Excellent. So could you show us anything else? Do you have another video or something that you could show us how this is working? I'd like to see that again.
Yeah. Okay. So.
Okay.
Here. So we can try and do a new one.
Okay. Excellent.
So, okay.
All right.
So here we are. We're going to try this again live.
Okay. First, we'll see how this works.
Yeah.
How's it going? And can you do multiple languages?
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay.
Okay. So basically, then what you're seeing here is you're getting the automatic translation.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to take a few seconds, especially because we're on 3G right now. And then after that, you can upgrade it automatically, right? So,
yeah.
And that's the thing at the end, you'll see it. You can post directly to Facebook or YouTube directly with the subtitles. So
wow.
Everything you post from here, you know, if I take one of the previous videos once it's upgraded and I post it, it will post it directly with all the subtitles so that anybody that is watching your video will immediately see the right subtitle in their language.
That is amazing. Well, look at that. It's happening right now as we speak. And you know, it's so important for the languages that Google's having problems with, Chinese, Japanese,
yeah,
to have that human gloss.
It is. That's the thing. our background is AI, and so when we started, we were very bullish on how fast we can get it to fully work. But a very interesting learning curve has been the demand for high quality output, right? Because we're so sensitive to language, right? If you talk to someone that has an accent, you're making assumptions on where they are. You know, it's the immediate way that we determine our tribe, right? If I speak like you, then you're kind of part of my tribe. If you speak the way that I do, then you're maybe in my profession. And when companies or when people don't quite, you know, are not able to produce a high quality interaction, then immediately we tend to think that there's something fishy. So one good example is e-commerce, right? When you see a product description that is machine translated, you start thinking maybe this is a scam. You lose confidence.
Yes.
Right? And language is fundamentally a great establisher of confidence and trust.
And one more question, how much does the subscription cost?
So we start at $500 a month, so $6,000 a year. We work on typically yearly subscriptions.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, we have customers that spend $100K a year, you know, a little bit more. Yeah.
Okay. What is this going to mean the end of the... Is this going to be the end... Step forward with me here. They're going to... Does this mean the end of the funny T-shirts that we can buy in Japan and Jakarta?
Well, yeah, I think so. I mean, you know, we'll have different memes and different ways of making fun, but I think until now, it was very common to find mistranslations were just funny, right? Mm-hmm. And I think we're kind of getting beyond that. So even on the neural machine translation part, it's very rare right now that you find something that is really egregious, like obvious, oh my God, I can't believe they said that, right? Mm-hmm. We're now at the level where it's, you know, one of the problems is sometimes it's just a difference, it means something different than the source, and other times it's just, it doesn't have that kind of human quality, right? It's somewhat either a little bit robotic or it's missing a few things, but not at the level that we were seeing before.
Right, right. It can be just a little off sometimes.
Yeah.
And someone else asks, are all the human corrections then stored and used to upgrade your model?
That's exactly it. That's exactly what's happening. So there's the virtuous feedback loop is everything that we do, everything that the humans do, then gets reinserted into the engine, so the engine keeps getting better. So there's a continuous learning process that, you know, is extremely fast. So even if we're working, for example, with a company that has no previous data, so that's been one of the issues with AI is, if you don't have data, you can't do anything. Mm-hmm. We have a very efficient way of generating data because we just, you know, in the beginning, we just run it through our community, and we have the initial data that can then enable us to domain adaptation.
Okay, now, here's an interesting question about content, and this is from Walter Verzawa. Are you fact-checking in translation, and are you omitting hate-related translation content?
That's a great question. So the short answer is right now we're not. I mean, we're very agnostic. Initially, we had an interesting case initially where there were, you know, someone was trying to send us content that we objected to. And we had an internally discussion, and the problem is we don't have the resources to really vet everything. And the problem is if you make an editorial decision of not taking in something, you know, as long as it's legal, then you're basically responsible for everything else. And as a startup, that's really hard, right? Because you don't have those resources. Even Google, I mean, a lot of times they get into trouble because even though they filter 99.9% of their content in YouTube, the thing that's left is still enough that can really create problems, right?
Right.
And so right now, as long as it's legal, it's agnostic.
Okay, and a little technical question for you here. Are the subtitles hard-coded in when exporting from the app?
No, it depends on the platform, but for both for YouTube and Facebook, you export it in an XLIF file, right? So you have a format that's specific for subtitles that you exported. Both Facebook and YouTube take that, mm-hmm. and then they can display it. For platforms like, you know, if you want to do Smart Check or Instagram, you would have to embed it directly into the image.
Okay. Someone else asks, how will translators know the context for the videos?
Say it again?
How will the translators know the context for the videos?
Well, that's a really hard problem, right? So a lot of times they have access to the video. They're seeing the video, right? Mm-hmm. And so that helps. Sometimes things out of context are just really hard to translate. It's the same problem in translation. If you just send a sentence without any context, it's very hard even for us humans to derive, right? The thing that helps is that typically because we're a subscription, we know which companies are sending the videos, so we can provide context of, you know, this is coming from this source, here's the goal, you know, the target is this. Customers can also provide information like, you know, the tone that they want or contextual information through the API.
Okay, all right. Well, that was an amazing demonstration. Thank you very much, Pedro.
Thank you.
Round of applause for Pedro.
Thank you.
Thank you.